Hey folks, welcome to Jurassic Park, or at the very least, a very cool movie-inspired Jurassic Park made by PZ Salmon over on the Nexus, and I'll of course link this down below so you can check it out for yourselves. This is not meant to be one-to-one accurate in terms of fences and paths and stuff like that, but it takes a lot of inspiration from the film, it adds some new exhibits, and it does recreate some exhibits directly. It's also got lots of very, very cool techniques involved, some really inventive new things that I'm going to showcase throughout this video. And along with that, we get to spend some time with some Jurassic Park dinosaurs and see some cool behaviours. And if you wanted some dinosaurs of your own with some cool behaviours, well, you should check out this message from today's sponsor. This is Beast Lord, a mobile strategy game and the most popular animal game in the world. There's over 500 animals. As a bonus, every animal comes with its own behaviours. You'll collect these creatures and then battle to take control of the world around you. Best in slot viewers, there's something more for you here. The Mega Beast system unlocks at level 16, and oh baby, this system is based entirely on dinosaurs. Ankylosaurus, Carnotaurus, Baryonyx, Brachiosaurus, and of course the Tyrannosaurus Rex. Now who doesn't want a dinosaur battling by their side? By defeating wild animals, you'll sometimes obtain a new Mega Beast egg, which you then need to put in a nest and feed with worms. How do you get worms, you ask? Well, you build a worm farm and then you supply it with honey. Eventually you'll have an egg, you'll have worms, and the hatching can begin. From egg to larva and then eventually to an adult, you'll get yourself a brand new dinosaur Mega Beast. But you know, maybe a repeat Mega Beast isn't a bad idea. Your Mega Beasts have star ratings that determine their strength, and these ratings can be increased by feeding the Mega Beast with another of the same kind. Why have two T-Rexes when you can have a Mega Rex? Eventually, you can then send these beasts to the Mega Beast habitat, where they will help boost up your territory and make it even stronger.
Best in slot, how do I get this for myself?
You can follow the link in the description to download the game for yourself. If you use my redeem code BL777, you'll get a bundle of resource supplies to help you out in the early game. Download it below and become the Beast Lord. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you some of these places on foot first, and then we're going to hop into one of the explorers and we're going to go on the full proper Jurassic Park tour, just like in the film. But there's a few cool locations that you can't see from the tour. Let's check those out first. And the first is over here. Of course, it would not be Jurassic Park without that quintessential classic waterfall scene with the helicopter opening everything up. Very cool, using our waterfall mods, of course. And then that will head off into the rest of the park. However, we've seen people recreate this plenty of times before. It's a great recreation, but we've seen it before. However, the cool part about this is actually down here. Now, this might not seem like a big deal, but I thought this was very clever. I don't really know how they've done it, but using pipes, I'm assuming from Malta, maybe? They've made this at this very start of Jurassic Park. There's this weird double-layered concrete filtration system or something on the left hand side of the helipad, which is covered in rocks as well, as it is in the film. Very cool. And I've never seen someone try to recreate this. I tried to recreate this and it was a disaster, so this was actually a really clever idea, and I just wanted to applaud that. You know, it's the little things, folks, that really bring a build together. Just a little bit down the road then, we've got our beautiful scene inspired by the first film of Brachiosauruses on this hilly, grassy, muddy outcrop kind of thing. You see the waterfall down there in the distance. We've even got a sleepy one, but that is, look, I know I gush about this all the time, but just seeing these brachies in the wild like this, just walking around, sounding so beautiful. That noise is more than the Rex, more than the Raptor. That noise is Jurassic Park to me, and it, all the nostalgia in the world. It makes me a little sad in a weird way. You know, that the warm sadness of nostalgia. It's beautiful. Now, obviously, this is not meant to be, as I say, completely film accurate. They're just here to, you know, take their role in the film. A little bit further on, of course, you would have your Jurassic Park Visitor Center looking beautiful, sitting in front of the little lake, little pond kind of thing, as you would expect. Even got these lovely little seating areas. Everyone's having a fantastic time. Now, the reason we pause here is that I've got one more mod I want to show you. This is a mod. This is a save file, but it does use a modded car. You wouldn't necessarily need to use this yourself, but I don't think I ever showcased this on the channel. I just kind of want to show it off for a second. This is the JP Explorer by Carlos2386, which adds tons of little details to the car that aren't there to make it more film accurate entirely. You'll see lots of little things, like we've got the Ford badge there, which I can see why isn't there on the official thing, but the extra lights and stuff like that up there. Inside, you'll see on the right hand side, if I just come around here, we've got glasses on the top. Of course, in reference to the famous scene with the glass moving around, and we've even got some brochures and stuff sitting on the back there. Just a nice little mod, you know, makes the Ford Explorer movie accurate, which is really cool. All those beautiful little extra details. So shout out to Carlos2386 for that. And I'm going to link that JP Explorer down below along with the map itself, just because I don't think I've ever quite highlighted it on the channel before, and it's awesome and it deserves it. All these lovely little details. So we're going to go back there at some point to check out the actual tour itself, but before we do that, let's have a little gander, a little wander around, and explore some of the on-foot portions of the park, which are movie-inspired, but of course invented, essentially, for the purposes of the save file. So I've got this lovely little, I mean, just really nicely decorated. I've got to say, the decoration work is absolutely on point. Wait, no, I'm Rudiger. Wow, the decorations are on point. It's like little benches here next to our rock displays. We've got our little Jurassic Park map over there. And of course, our gigantic Rex Skeleton welcoming us into the park, and Hammond himself welcoming us as well. Some people are just here to sit down. Come to a theme park to sit down. Amazing. So you walk forward a little bit, you've got your Jurassic Park advertisement in front of you. To the right down there is heading towards the visitor center. We instead are going to go left towards this really, really cool hotel kind of area just up here on the left-hand side. Because I, Rudiger, I'm very tired from my long flight. I would like to sit down before I go look at the dinosaurs. Got a security bunker, got a security tower kind of thing, and then open this. Feels very exclusive, you know, I'm a fancy boy with my fancy things. And we head up and look, the return of Big Tree. The beloved Big Tree is finally back. And yeah, this really, really nice, nicely designed hotel kind of section using these chiodenic little fences to kind of just make it feel a lot more, I don't know, human appropriate, I suppose would be the word. And we can have a little poke around. Got a lovely little seating area by the fountain, lots of foliage. We've got a raised sort of lodge area up here as well, surrounded by some skeletons, which is what you want from your housing. And of course, the safari lodges all around the side as well. It's just really, really beautifully done. And you can look out over the edge and see a dinosaur exhibit, which has dinosaurs in it, I'm pretty sure. I can't see them. But you know what? It wouldn't be Jurassic Park if the first dinosaur we try to see on the tour, we can't see. That's proper Jurassic Park right there. Malcolm would be having a field day. I'm sure there's dinosaurs in there. They're all over here, look. Over there in the tree line, the Gallimimus wandering around. So I think this is maybe a slight nod to the Gallimimus scene as well. With that done, we are going to go back and we are going to hop on the park tour. We're going to get out again a little bit later on at relevant points. Come back here, please. And here we go. So can I go one car forward? All right, there we go. That took bloody ages. Completely forgot all the hotkeys. So let's chill in the car and enjoy our tour around Jurassic Park being driven, which again makes zero sense to me and will never make any sense to me. Why is there a driver in an on-rails tour? Who knows? But the cars can drive off, and I guess they would look like they've been controlled by ghosts, which is cool, but maybe not Jurassic Park appropriate. We've got all this lovely stuff. Of course, we've got the glasses there. Very cool. There's even some water in them, ready to ripple as need be. And we are approaching, on the right-hand side, our first paddock. And of course, it is a beautiful but deadly addition to Jurassic Park. It is the Dilophosaurus. And as per usual, I would be slightly disappointed if I could actually see it. They're a very shy dinosaur, and we're never allowed to actually see them in our park. I feel like every time I do a Jurassic Park recreation tour, because, you know, a lot of people have made things not dissimilar to this. Oh, there we go. Hello, buddy. Oh, we actually saw them. I mean, that's the first time we've ever seen the Dilophosaurus on one of these tours. There they are. Very cool. I've got a lovely tilted fences, of course. They've been playing Fortnite all day, and they're not in a great mood about it, to say the least. Leave our dilos behind and move on. Okay, next part begins. We've got a little bunker over here on the left-hand side. Bunker, bunker, bunker. And God, lives rent-free in my head, the bunker. And then this rock tunnel, really nicely recreated. Pain in the ass to do this kind of thing. I know that myself all too well. And of course, you do very briefly glimpse these tunnels in the film, particularly when they're entering the Tyrannosaurus Rex area. But this is actually a Velociraptor paddock. I'm just going to remember the correct button, maybe. Yes, there we go. We've got our raptor paddock there, our sunken raptor paddock. Looks like it's still being built a little bit. It's interesting. Of course, you don't see the raptor paddock in the film. We just see the hatchery and stuff like that. We'll maybe take another look at that in just a second and see if we can get a slightly better view. It's fun with a tour. You're always zooming by, as it were. Oh, it's not a bunker. It's like a generator kind of thing, right? Built into the wall. That's cool. Okay, so we've seen the Dilophosaurus, we've gone past the Raptor Paddock, and now we have, again, thanks to some fantastic mods, this humongous grassy mountain, leafy mountain that we're about to drive past or enter. It's actually hard to say. I think we're going to go inside it. Can we go? We've got like a vampire situation. I need to ask permission before I enter the mountain. Maybe it's a very different thing. Either way, this should, I think, probably take us to the Tyrannosaurus Rex paddock, if I had to guess, but we will find out in just a moment. Okay, here we go. It does look Rex paddock themed to me, so you do see, you kind of just about see the exit of that tunnel in the film. Of which this very real park, Iron Rudiger, is based on, of course. It was inspired by the real-life Jurassic Park, which existed canonically in human history. And here we have our lovely classic tilted fences again. Probably a little chasm down there. You can see the trees kind of sinking down. There's a big drop down there, as you would expect. And somewhere on the left, we're looking at this exhibit. There's the goat. Where's the Rex? You know... Oh, well, there's the bathrooms, and there's the T-Rex sign. Very cool. No Rex yet, but that's okay. Look, we're on a tour. We don't get to choose where the dinosaurs appear from. You know, we are at the whims of nature, which is kind of the lesson of Jurassic Park. So, you know, pay attention. Don't think we're going to see the Rex, though. Beautiful exhibit, though. Nicely designed. Nice big open area over here on the right, which always made more sense. Like, the Rex seemed very confined to the forest in what we see in the film. It needed, like, some bright open spaces to properly hunt in, really. Doesn't look like we're going to see it today. Maybe we'll hop in the chopper later on and see if we can get a better look. Looks like we're entering the Triceratops paddock. Hello, beautiful. There they are. So on a little hill, as you would expect, of course. In the film, we see Grant et al. Hop out of the car here, hop down the hill, and into the paddock. This paddock is much, much happier looking than the one we see in the film. Lots of happy feeding triceratopses. Looking absolutely beautiful under that lighting. Oh, having a little tussle. Oh. You tell Lady Margaret. Hello, beautiful. I still love that JP skin. It's fantastic. Carry on nipping it down. I know, like, none of you, like, you would have a terrible view right here. They need like a bubble in the ceiling, like in a meerkat exhibit, so you can hop up and look around. Need four bubbles at varying heights, I guess. So the two on the right should be higher, and then they should go lower if the exhibit's on the right. Does that make sense? I don't know. We've got some nice little details here, these extra decorations. Oh no, this is the camera stop. Smile for the camera. Whee! Put your arms in the air, like you just don't care. Looks like we're entering the Gallimimus paddock. Are we going to see a big old log? No, we've already seen the Dilophosaurus. Sorry, it's an old joke at this point. It's really cool seeing the hot air balloons in the distance as well. It's like Jurassic Park if Jurassic Park was fully formed, you know? If they kept going, they kept developing, they finished everything off, and we've got all these different attractions. We've got some creatures who we didn't see in Jurassic Park or weren't planned, but would have been added down the line, potentially. Okay, we didn't see any galleys. The galleys are all down there. They're posing for the people in the hotels. I think we've got about a 50% hit rate so far on whether we get to see a dinosaur in an exhibit. So, what do we have over here? We've got this lovely raised area. It looks fantastic. It's like muddy outcrop. I think that looks like a stegosaurus there in the distance, grazing this beautiful open field sort of area. Again, a dinosaur we don't see in the original Jurassic Park. We see them on Isla Sorna, not Isla Nublar, but a perfect fit for the park. I think Stegosaurus, Triceratops, Brachiosaurus would be like the three quintessential Jurassic Park herbivores. And I feel like I'm probably missing something horrible by saying that. I'm not sure what it would be. But when I think Jurassic Park herbivores, those are the three I think of. Which, you know, fair play for Stegosaurus, because it's barely in the films. Other than that initial scene at the start of Jurassic World, Lost World Jurassic Park. And of course it is in Jurassic World as well. Actually pops up all the time, but it's never the focus. You know what I mean? Anyways, lovely little Stego habitat here with this raised tour around the outside. Again, utilizing those Kaio, a very famed Jurassic architect, Kaio's unique fence design. This exhibit actually reminds me a little bit of the Lady Margaret scene when you first spot her in Jurassic Park the game. There they go, beautiful. So we do actually also have an exhibit here. So we've got a big old lodge, safari thingamajiggy over there on the right. And then on the left, we've got an exhibit. I can't remember what it is. It might be Suchomimus. There's a viewing area over there in the middle. Yeah, you can just see some Suchos there in the distance. Very cool. I'm going to drive around here, this lovely blocked off fenced in area. Hopefully it's not going to kick me out of the car. Can't remember if it does, actually. It does indeed. Okay, well, you know what? We'll hop. I've been booted out. We may as well have a look around. Yeah, we've got a safari lodge sitting here. We've got a couple of different shops and stuff, restrooms. It's just like a little, it's another place to get into the park, I think is the idea. You know, you'd go and you'd stay in the safari lodge, you'd wake up in the morning feeling like P. Diddy, and you'd hop into your Jurassic Park Explorer. You know, P. Diddy was well known for his love of Jurassic Park. So we are going to go back over here and we are going to hop on the tour once again. So as I say, we've got the Suchomimus exhibit on the left. Of course, you would expect lots of water. You can see a couple of them skulking through the water over there in the distance, flanked by this little visitor thingamajiggy, security thing. Hiding in the trees because they hate me and they hate society. And yet they partake in society. Curious. Oh, she's posing for the photo. Who? You've changed. You've become a different person since we went through the vehicle depot thing. Now, this billboard is relevant. It's advertising the Jungle River Cruise thingamajiggy, and we will be partaking in that in just a moment when we get out at our next stop, which I think might just be over here in front of us. This area is probably the biggest walking area of the park. We're going to see some lagoon creatures, and of course we're going to see a Jungle River Cruise ride. So please keep your arms and legs inside the enclosed vehicle. I don't know how you would do it otherwise, but do it anyway. And I will, oh, okay, there's nothing there. I become you, destroyer of worlds. So let's take a look. We've just hopped out of the Jurassic Park tour. If we go forward, there's a lovely little restroom area. There's a lot of people. There's a lovely little restroom area, as you can see, just nestled in here. This actually doesn't look like much, but it is, you know, all these little rocks and little plants and stuff like that. It looks very well made, very professional, very tied together. Great, a little sign for the lagoon. Let's go check it out. Again, we've got the giant Mayan head, which is my favorite decoration in the mods. Hello. And then we've got the rock wall fiery things. Official term, by the way. Again, utilizing the modded trees really well to make a very dramatic looking signage, a very dramatic looking fountains and stuff like that. So this is our lagoon area, of course. Something's gone bonkers over there. Some of our modded buildings, grab a picture. You know, you've posed in front of the Mosasaurus. You get stuck on the invisible wall. I can't walk towards the building. He can walk towards the building. He's one of God's favorite children. Yeah, the building hates me. I think down there's more utility stuff like that. Let's go check out this building. There we go. Lovely stuff. So as you can see, we've got our Nothosaurus. We've got our Dunkleosteus over there. Very cool. Got lots of rock work there. Dunkle. Looking beautiful. Of course, Dunkle wasn't there in Jurassic Park, but if Jurassic Park had continued to develop, who knows? You know, who's to say Dunkle wouldn't have made it? It does have, you know, it's got teeth. It's, you know, armored. It's got that kind of Jurassic Park vibe to it. Really nicely decorated lagoon over here. Do you know what? I am in control. Let's go up and take a little look from above as well. Very dramatic. Big fiery lagoon. Got a couple shark feeder thingamajiggies. There you go, hello buddy. And of course a Nothosaurus resting perch there as well. And a little fishy. Hello, little fishy. Hello, I am little fishy. Have a little look in there quickly. Why not? Oh, there's our... we've got a Chronosaurus as well. Maybe it's a replacement for the JPTG... hello, beautiful Tylosaurus, which of course we have, but doesn't look appropriate for just part of the game. Hello, Dunkey. I wish you were tiny. Anyways, leaving the lagoon behind, we can head down here. We can sprint through people because I'm a VIP. Thank you very much. I'm just reminded of when the gang go to the water park in Always Sunny Philadelphia. Here we have a beautifully made river tour, jungle river cruise kind of area. Humongous use of the shelter kind of thing. Looks really good. We've got some bridge in the middle, which I cannot walk over because it's a mod and it's not how mods work, but you can see it's all connected through the middle there. The shelter keeps disappearing. It's very, very disconcerting, but it looks really cool. Really big shout out to I always get mixed up if it's Sir Zero John or RDRRR 1985. They both do phenomenal decoration work. I think this is Sir Zero John though, if I remember correctly. Grab yourself a picky wicky, grab yourself a crab, which feels appropriate, I suppose. We've got the Jurassic Park OG Nublar map there with the rivers highlighted, showing you where your cruise is gonna go. And of course you can hop on the cruise itself. Now we can't because, can we? Oh, this works. I never get this to work. Why does this work for other people? We can actually go on the Jungle River. I swear I've never seen this work for me before. This is the Jungle River Cruise. Very cool. Let me try to find some dinosaurs. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Triceratops. Going a little bit ham here. Hello. Aw. Isn't this very, very cool? Hello. I'm gonna hit you, yeah. Aww. Oh no, you decided to just hike. Okay, yeah, it's your prerogative, buddy. You do what you like. It's not a big tour. I'll just show you this from above very quickly. Quite a small tour, as you can see. Just takes you around this middle island bit. We've got the waterfall over there. Lots of lovely dinosaurs. And this is the whole area from above. We've got one more exhibit just to have a little peek at over here. This is pretty cool, though. The way the signage is built into the rock work, as you can see. And using... I think these are from Scary Face, but I don't like to talk about that unless I'm convinced. These really cool, so it's the Les Gigantes mural, you know, from the original Jurassic Park, from the E3 update that we had for the anniversary, but they've replaced it with glass instead. So it makes these really cool glass walls that you can then, you know, put a load of rock around, and looks fantastic. It looks really good. And then we've got a little compy exhibit, inspired a little bit by The Lost World. You know, they're on a beach with a little bit of tropical in there, and there's a small child on the feeder. There's our compies. And I really like this. This is a great idea. Having the rock wall at the side and then building the bunker kind of thing into it, because it just looks like a little staff area. I really, really like that as an idea, actually. I think that's very, very clever. I'm going to very much be stealing that one. I think that's genius. It looks really good. It looks very professional. It looks like something I would build like on Planet Zoo or something, which for evolution I think is really impressive. Just while I remember, I'm going to give you a quick look at this is the... actually, this is fantastic as well. This is the Velociraptor paddock from earlier. Of course, we don't really see all this concrete detail when we're driving through, but that's where we drove through, and here's our raptors hanging out, killing goats, doing Velociraptor things, basically. And that actually goes all the way down here, and you can see this is their where the park staff would enter. We've even got like a little watchtower thing in the area, which feels very appropriate for the Velociraptors. I love this kind of thing, though. These... using the concrete, using the walls and stuff to to build something that looks a lot more realistic than just driving over terrain. You know, it's got proper support and it looks great. In a similar vein, we can't do a Jurassic Park tour without checking out the Rex. So there she is, Rexy, stalking around her habitat. Take a quick little poke in here as well. Hello, old girl, how you doing? You are old by this point. She'd be towards the end of her life, to say the least, old Rexy. Even if she had hypergrowth and hyperspeed. Like Sonic. There she is. She's gonna do the thing. She's gonna do the thing. She did the thing. But we are not done yet. We are back on our tour, leaving behind that lagoony sort of area and heading back into the tunnel system. I'm gonna take over your body for a minute. What have we got in that? I actually can't tell what that is. Starting around in the distance. I think it's Herrerasaurus. I think that was Herrerasaurus. Only a very scant glimpse of that one. Of course, Herrerasaurus, another one of those dinosaurs that was actually planned to be in Jurassic Park, or does at least have a... I don't think there's ever really talk about it being in the film, but it does have an exhibit on the map. It's one of those dinosaurs that is listed on the map. Okay, approaching our next paddock. What are we looking at over here? Looks like an Ankylosaurus habitat. And a crazy balloon. The balloons are... It's kind of like a horror film, where you start to see like the sci-fi invaders, and initially there's just one, and then there's two, and then it just sort of gathers up over time, and slowly but surely, more hot air balloons are gathering overhead. It's like a rival, basically, but with hot air balloons. Yeah, this really nice sunken Ankylosaurus habitat there. All of them using slightly different techniques, slightly different fences and stuff like that, which I think is really nice. Got a little seating area over here if you wanted to hop out and look at the Yankees, which I absolutely would. And of course, it is our Jurassic Park 3 skin, which feels very appropriate. Hello, beautiful. Everyone's beautiful, by the way. All dinosaurs are beautiful. I can't help it. Just on God, someone come up with this analogy. Let me meet and see... Oh, very tired. A non-avian dinosaur in my lifetime. I swear there's even more balloons now. I said there's like six now. There was five a second ago. Well, it looks like we have another stop on our tour, and if I'm not crazy, we are going to be checking out the aviary. I can just about make out some of that wireframing over there on the left-hand side, so you keep changing. Well, it'd be very nice if this was added, that when you get here, it A, keeps the UI off, but it also just drops you off here, you know, in first-person mode. I think that would feel a lot better. I'd love to see that added to the game. So this aviary looks fantastic. We've got a couple of really cool things here. We've got this little display in the middle. The aviary itself, as you can see, is kind of folded into with the Teratops Lodge. This gigantic, it's like this floating hadrosaur that keeps appearing. Like I'm being haunted by the ghost of a hadrosaur. Yeah, the Teratops Lodge looks really cool there. There's a staircase, you climb up into there and you'd, you know, it's kind of built into the aviary itself so you could have a look inside. Using the Mayan decorations there into the walls as well. Hello, buddy. Looks fantastic. I don't remember this as a decoration. This must be like something sunk down into the ground, like a pyramid or something, maybe? And then just before we check out the aviary itself, if we hop down here to the left through this humongous crowd of people, you'll see that we've got the balloon tour. We've even got the sign for it. Again, really nice little details. We can hop up here. Around to the side, there's our aviary there and our aviary entrance. We'll check that out in a second. And of course, the top of the Teratops Lodge. Again, fantastic decoration work in the mods. And up here, we actually have the balloon tour. Now, I said that the other thing didn't work. I don't think the balloon tour works, but we're going to try it anyway because I've been wrong many times. There's Mr. DNA. Howdy, folks. I think that's Mr. Hanky. Wait, what the hell? I didn't know you could do this. I've never been able to do this, I swear. Is it fixed? Was it patched or... Oh, I don't know. I'm very confused. There's our lagoon ride over there, our Jungle River Cruise. There's, of course, our aviary, our Teratops Lodge. Can hop around a little bit and have a little... Whoa. Here we've got one of the exhibits. There's our Ankylosaurus exhibit. It's our raptors over there on the left. Can I change camera? Oh, look at this! This is mad! This is so good! I'd be a little terrified. I'm very on board. Man, I didn't know. This is revolutionary for me. It genuinely is. I'm blown away. Look at Larry just hanging with the lads and the lasses. Or whatever you want to be. You're sending a ball of light. You can be wherever you want to be. That's okay. In the hot air balloon. 6 feet apart. All right, let's go check out the aviary. Very cool, though. Again, both of those rides have never worked for me, so I don't know what's going on. But I have no complaints. It's very cool to see them in action like that. Let's have a little peek inside this aviary and see what we have got. Of course, we're expecting Pteranodon, but will we see anything else? Oh, the tour actually goes through the aviary. I had no idea. That's awesome. We'll see that in just a second then. You see there's our classic Pteranodons. And I don't know if there's anything else. But the Pteranodons are very cool. You could maybe throw in some Jurassic World stuff here, but it is meant to be Jurassic Park, so you're not going to really see your Dimorphodons, for example. It does look like it's just Pteranodons, but the tour looks really cool going through there, so let's go check that out in what I think is the last leg of our vehicle tour. It is indeed the last leg, but it's also quite a long one. Lots of cool things to see. Let's get going. And here we are then, about to enter the aviary. We've got some lovely signs. Of course, you may have seen my mod spotlight video. I don't know when you'll see this video, but if you have, you'll see we've got some fantastic new signs as well, thanks to Scary Face. Here we are. We've got our hatchery there on the left. The balloons haunting me, as always, although the floating hadrosaur seems to have disappeared for now. So Pteranodons over there. And, oh, loads of them up there on that tall roosting spot. Again, I love seeing that Teratops Lodge just poking in at the side. Oh, we do have Dimorphodons. Hello. Dimorphodons there as well. And as long as you keep yourself inside the vehicle, you would not die. This is the equivalent. Okay, Pteranodons could do a lot more damage. But again, it's kind of like the monkey exhibit back in Knowsley Safari Park. You know, people drive through lion exhibits all the time in reality. And most of the time, they just leave you alone. I don't think there's any reason to think that the Pteranodons wouldn't basically do the same thing. And that we'd be okay. Ah, oh, yes, this is exactly, you know, the glass ceiling doesn't make sense for many dinosaurs. Brachiosaurus, Tyrannosaurus Rex are really the only two in the original Jurassic Park. But then you drive through the aviary, you get a sight of a Pteranodon flying directly over your head. It's very, very cool. I'm going to get a glass top car just for this purpose. Some people would call it a sunroof, but that's stupid. Okay, our next exhibit is a carnivore of some description. You can tell by the sign, but also the fact that we're raised up a little bit, you know, we're protected. Looks like it is our Metriacanthosaurus, which of course was also present in the original Jurassic Park, but never had its own, never got showcased in the film. Looking beautiful down there, that classic Jurassic World style design, really, taken straight from the website, but really cool to see that. So popular and canonized almost. This little doohickey in the middle has been going bonkers for the entire video. Okay, looks like we're entering another drive-through exhibit. The dinosaurs are in here with us, but what are we? Is it Coelophysis? It looks a little big to be Coelo. Is it Coelo? Why can't I tell what you are? It's Coelophysis. It's Coelophysis. I suspect what this is meant to represent is Segisaurus, which of course is one of the few canonical dinosaurs that we don't have in evolution at the moment. Wait, no, I'm Rudiger. I like dinosaurs. There you go. Everyone's convinced? We're okay. Segisaurus hasn't made it in. We haven't developed the technology yet to clone Segisaurus. But Coelophysis is a pretty good halfway to getting us there. Hello, beautiful. That's very well timed. Iguanodon making an appearance. Looking absolutely stunning. I really like this original. You know, it's not using the Dominion version, which is an interesting choice. But the original Jurassic World version is still, Jurassic World Evolution version is still pretty great. There are good and bad bits for both, I would suggest. Hello, lovely. She's come to say hello. There's a big old iguana. I don't have it. Again, loads of room for the herbivores to roam around in. It's seen, oh, there's one there in the distance as well. Is that an iguana? Yeah, it must be. It looks like a something much more terrifying, but it must be an iguanodon. They wouldn't put a Rex in with the iguanodons, right? Millie? And I think things are about to wrap up. I think this is our last habitat until we get back to the visitor center. But of course, we're now driving through a lovely Brachiosaurus habitat. Please? No. Your head is in exactly the wrong place. So I can't. You're just this headless demon. Stop taking pictures of me. I did not consent to my data being shared like this. We'll leave the demon behind. See if we spot anything else in this, again, beautiful, large herbivore paddock. The entire park just wraps around so nicely. It's really well made, really intricate in how the paths and the tour and everything sort of joins together in all these different areas where you can walk around. It's just a really, really well made park with lots of fantastic Jurassic Park references. But, you know, also, like, if Jurassic Park had survived, if Jurassic Park opens in the 1990s and, you know, everything doesn't go to hell, you know, and the park manages to stay afloat and it keeps developing and we never get Jurassic World, instead we just get a developed Jurassic Park, maybe it's something akin to this, you know, maybe this is where Jurassic Park was meant to end up, really. Very fortunate, a little bit more Brachiosaurus action to finish off the day. Coming over here to pose by the camera, I think. This would be a nice time to get that photo. You know, you see the Brachiosaurus shambling towards your car and you're looking out the window in amazement. No posing, just living in the moment. You know, no mobile phones in Jurassic Park. If you want a photo, pay 20 quid for it. Oh, there's another one, hello. Pay 25 quid for it at a photo booth like the rest of us do, goddammit. And folks, I think that comes to the end of our tour. That was nearly English. So I think you've seen basically everything. I'll give you a quick overview just from the sky. There was one little thing I wanted to show you, and I've not been able to find it on the map at all. I figured it would be in the Dilophosaurus habitat, but I couldn't seem to see it. They did this little thing with, I think it's meant to be resembling the Dilophosaurus habitat. And I think it's meant to be the sort of the mud and the water with the canister and stuff like that. So there's also these little areas over here. It's like this in development hotel sort of area, or, you know, more sort of staff sort of thing as well. Yeah, just a really, really cool, expansive build. Lots of different things. Feels like a modern Jurassic Park. You know, still quite flat and stuff like that, which you'd expect the Jurassic Park to be. It's not overly fancy, but really nicely decorated. All very tightly designed, as you can see as well. A fantastic, fantastic Jurassic Park. So shout out to them, and shout out again to Carlos2386, and of course to RDRR and Sir Zero John for their decorations and stuff like that, and Scaryface, and probably a billion, and Inaki and Kaio, and a gajillion other people who make things like this possible. The balloons, the 7 of them now. Right, anyways, yes, if you want to support me and the channel, also nip down below to the description, you know, maybe get yourself some beasts, some mega beasts. And I can do this. I'm a professional YouTuber. And yeah, I'll thank you so much for joining me. Throw me a like if you enjoyed the video. I'll see you lovely folks very soon. Cheers, much of us always. Bye-bye. Oh.